mid-2004, your then CEO comes to you and says he thinks the two of you should consider selling the company. Your reaction to that and how it impacted your view of him?
I was completely shocked. I thought he was in some emotional state that I didn't quite understand. I never would have thought of that. It was never, ever in my, I told him, we're never selling this company. I don't care what. This, we're not, we did that once with the B of A. We're not doing it again, even if we were rough times.
And how quickly in that moment do you realize,
has to be made? Very quickly, within a couple months, the board came to me and said, the CEO at the time, we don't think he can continue to have the confidence of the board, and we think he needs to go. And they said, would you come back as CEO? I was chairman, of course. And I said, obviously no problem, I'd come back. So the next day, we had to take on the CEO at the time and fire him. And that was not a pleasant time for anybody. Firing anybody is no fun, but it was the right thing to do.
Describe what that's like for you, though. Here you are, 67 years old, and all of a sudden you're the CEO again. And where did you think you'd be at that place in life?
I thought it'd be more time on the golf course.
Right.
I had to forget golf for a number of months, for a year, basically. It's like if you've ever had this sense, you've ever been around a fire hose, a fire engine with a hose. It's like having four of those hoses in your mouth